Amen. Thank you, Lord, that I know this is a home, Lord, celebration. I know your heart's so heavy, but God is still God. He still is. He still is a people. He still is a redeemer. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless you, Jesus. At this time, we come to have a moment of common holiday. And finally, common holiday. We have a sense of unity. We have a nation. We ask that you come and live. death and trouble, the captain from the night, and the place is separate from the night. If you come back to the room, it will be a fierce looking figure that I'm done with the death of the night, and you will stand up. My God, it will be a new day, and I'm just going to be a new day. I'm going to be a new day. I'm going to be a new day. blessed the Lord of my life. Come on, I guess your testimony, son, that you will not complain. You cannot complain, but you will not complain. Come on, we come to celebrate, my brother. Come on, we not going to complain because the Lord gave us 44 years, 528 months, 16,000 days to be with brother Robert. So we're going to lift our hands and say, Lord, thank you. We won't complain, God. We thank you for the life, God, that you share with us. Come on, let's lift the Lord and thank God for you. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
is just to make sure that all of us are alive. We have to make sure that we know everything, because we don't know where we might take our lives. In the midst of your work being ready to be, in the midst of you feeling the trouble in your home, you got to keep in mind that no one is ready to bring all the time in which to serve a God's fair opinion. I come to tell you, my brothers and sisters, that we don't get to understand that life is a promise in any way, and we don't get to understand that why we don't hear a different one. So we got to live and serve the Lord. I don't think that many women who work in here, but one thing we got to understand is that everybody wants to go to heaven, but there's only one way you can get to heaven, and you just believe today that God is faithful, that He's got His ticket in His hands. I know that God is faithful. I know that He's so loyal to many of you that I can hear some of the pressure of my voice. And the one thing you can do is that you think of them that will keep the memory that you'll be able to wait for forever. That I'll give you a reason to let you hear. That the one thing that God can mistake, that He calls your heart to be ready, that He calls your name to wear it for tears. The one thing that God can take away, take away the memory, take the reason, let them hear, take away all the good things you heard, take away all the memories that you share for the Christian faith, and let take away all of the good conversations that you had to hear about it ever, take the reason, let them hear, and you look over, and you see these children, that are seeing the people, became a good hand. But she was not. That's what they took to do. Because they were so you owe it. The children of you that they never do. You owe it. The children of men that you think you have to. And I know that they did if you keep it to yourself. You don't do it with the children of men. So I make you believe. And he said to them, hallelujah. Hallelujah. In spite of it all, he still is a good man. He will. I'm going to go to the hospital.